Canada's decision to replace its aging CF-18 fleet triggered one of the most exhaustive fighter assessments in the country's history. After a global competition, the final contenders were narrowed to two: the U.S. Air Force's F-35A, Lightning II, and Sweden's Saab Gripen E. When evaluation results were released, the outcome was decisive. The F-35 didn't merely outperform the Gripen E, it dominated almost every major category, winning by an overwhelming technical margin. At the heart of Canada's assessment were mission performance, survivability, upgradability, interoperability, and long-term relevance. Across all of them, the F-35 demonstrated capabilities that the Gripen E simply could not match. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how F-35A trounced Gripen E in Canadian evaluations. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Canada's defense environment poses unique strategic challenges: vast territory, long-range threats, potential Arctic missions, and integration with multinational defense frameworks like NORAD and NATO. According to official evaluation data, the F-35 received 57.1 out of 60 points, while the Gripen E scored 19.8 out of 60. The widest gap came in mission performance, where the F-35 scored nearly 5 times higher than the Gripen. This dramatic difference underscores a simple reality. The two aircraft are built for different eras of warfare. Gripen E is a modern 4.5 generation fighter. The F-35 is a true fifth-generation platform designed for contested, high-threat environments. This development comes as countries like Canada reassess their defense strategies amid Russia's war in Ukraine and rising concerns about U.S. political reliability. Tensions between Ottawa and Washington have sharpened recently, with U.S. President Donald Trump imposing tariffs and even suggesting that Canada consider becoming the 51st American state. Saab has also aggressively pushed for the Canadian contract. It announced the Gripen for Canada team in March 2020. The campaign was a multi-year marketing, lobbying, and industrial partnership initiative to position the Jazz 39 Gripen EF multi-role fighter jet as the preferred replacement. While the decision is pending, F-35 has come out at the top in hard technical evaluations. Let's check the aspects one by one. The most significant gap between Gripen E and the F-35 is stealth. The F-35 is a fifth-generation stealth fighter designed from the ground up with a low-radar cross-section, RCS, infrared and electromagnetic emissions management, and internal weapons carriage to avoid detection. Together, these features give F-35s a first-look, first-kill advantage and allow them to penetrate defended airspace while remaining undetected or difficult to engage. By contrast, Gripen E does not have stealth shaping or internal weapon base. Its radar cross-section is greater, and its emissions are more easily detected. While it includes modern radar, the Raven ES-05, AESA, and an IRST, infrared search and track sensor suite, those provide situational awareness but cannot mask the aircraft's signature. In contested airspace, especially one with sophisticated surface-to-air missiles, integrated air defense systems, or radar networks optimized for small RCS detection, the Gripen would be far more vulnerable. In modern high-end combat scenarios, survivability often depends on not being seen at all. From that perspective, the F-35's stealth and signature management give it a qualitatively different class of survivability that Gripen simply cannot offer. A core strength of the F-35 is its advanced sensor fusion and data integration architecture. The jet combines radar, infrared, electronic warfare sensors, and I/O from allied assets into a unified real-time battlespace picture. This fusion enables pilots to detect, track, and prioritize threats long before hostiles detect them, essentially turning the F-35 into a flying data node for itself and other platforms. While Gripen E has strong sensors, it does not integrate them at the same level. It informs the pilot, it doesn't fuse the world around them. These systems make it a capable multi-role fighter for conventional air defense, ground attack, or patrols, but its sensor fusion capabilities are not at the level of a fully integrated fifth-generation system. Moreover, Gripen's sensors and avionics architecture were designed for flexibility and low operating costs rather than deep integration with high-end network-centric warfare environments. While software upgrades are possible, the underlying framework limits its potential as a network combat node. One of the key areas of Canada's evaluation was upgradability. Gripen scored just 28%, far behind F-35's 100%. This reflects structural and design limitations. Gripen E remains a 4.5 generation aircraft with compromises built in for affordability, maintenance, and ease of operation. Its airframe does not have the internal volume for future stealth upgrades or advanced internal weapons bays. Retrofits like conformal fuel tanks, larger avionics suites, or electronic warfare enhancements are possible, but they cannot close the fundamental gap in signature management and stealth. By contrast, the F-35 was designed with an evolutionary upgrade path, with modular sensors, weapons, and software updates. For a country like Canada, which expects an Air Force to remain relevant over decades, that longevity and open-ended growth path carry significant value. It's true the Gripen E is significantly cheaper to buy, fly, and sustain than the F-35. Most analyses list lower fuel consumption, simpler systems, and lower hourly flying costs as major advantages. For a country with limited defense budgets or mostly low-intensity needs, that may be attractive. However, that advantage is only relevant if the geopolitical environment remains stable and adversaries don't deploy modern radars, advanced air defenses, or stealth detection tools. A 4.5 generation fighter will be more or less obsolete in near future and may not be very effective if Canada gets embroiled in a high-end conflict with a country like Russia. The fact is that for long-term strategic parity, cost savings alone doesn't justify capability deficits.